Came to see your sister, say right?
Oh, yeah. She's gone out?
Yeah, she's gone out.
Gone to school, I guess.
Yeah,
I need to talk to you though. I have good news for you.
Really?
Yeah, but we have to talk about it inside.
Your sister might.
Oh, don't worry, I won't take much of your time. Let's go inside, okay?
Yeah, let me just pop up.
It's okay.
Hey, this tiny Jamie. She's standing in front of the TV.
She's lying, no brother. She refused to give me food.
Will you shut up? Are you a baby? Can't you go to the kitchen and make something for yourself?
Rita, you know I can't cook. And you won't even teach me how to cook.
Because you're not serious. Big tea like you.
Can't cook.
back.
Down. Sit.
I don't like this. What is it? Tell me. What do you have to say?
Like me? Don't you love me? Am I not beautiful enough?
That is not the issue.
Can't you see?
That is not the issue. You don't have something going on with your sister. Stop! Is this why you called me in?
Okay, come. Okay.
Is this why you called me in?
Calm down, honey. Come. Let me tell you something.
I think I'll
tell you. Okay, last thing I'll tell you. Just come. Tell you the last thing. Just sit. Sit down. Good boy. Wow. Why are you giving me so much tough time? Alright, maybe if I give you something that will make you happy, I'll probably change your mind.
Something like what?
I have prepared it for a very long time. I was waiting for this special day. Today is a special day, Bobby. Today is a special day. Bobby. Ta-da!
What?
I'll
close for the day then.
Okay,
that's enough. Let's go now. Come on. I have to get back to it.
Listen. You look sad. What's the problem?
It's Shanice.
Shanice? What about Shanice?
She beat up Angela and slapped me while we were watching TV.
Shanice beat up Angela and slapped
her.
Are you sure? What did both of you do?
We were only discussing about ourselves when she came in.
And?
We greeted her and she gave Angela a slap on the face.
Samson!
She also slapped me too and drove Angela away from the house, calling her a tat.
Tat? What for?
I begged Angela to come back, but she refused.
It's okay, my darling brother. I'll talk to Shanice.
What about Angela?
I'll talk to Angela too. I mean, I will call Angela and beg her to come back.
Coming over, see Angela.
Tomorrow. Please let's go. Welcome, Shanice.
Oh, thank you, Sharon.
You're welcome, Sharon.
How it worked today?
It was fine, thank you. And yours?
Oh, it was okay. Are you going out?
Yeah, I just came in and I'm going out again. Well, it's about Samson and Angela. Did you really beat Angela up and slap Samson?
Yes. And what is your business about that?
How do you mean?
Oh, I can see. You are now the one in charge of this house, right?
Can't I ask a question?
No, 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 not supposed to. Big fool.
Ah.
Shut up, you big fool. You think I'm done with you? I'm still going to get my money from you. Big fool.
It's just because I asked a question.
You don't have to
ask.
Mommy,
Sharon.
Sharon, what happened? Samson, what happened?
It's Shanice. She has started with that ugly attitude of hers again.
Oh yeah now, and you boys, you know Shelly, and shine your MVP. But see where we're going. Let's go. And tell us the joy.
Shayo, he gon' make you so dizzy. Shayo, he gon' make you so dizzy. Shayo, he gon' make you so dizzy. Shayo for this party, oh Shayo, he gon' make you so dizzy. Shayo, he gon' make you so dizzy. Shayo, he gon' make you so dizzy. Shayo for this party, oh Shayo.
This is the party for the big boys, for the big girls. Boy Shayo, girl Shayo, everybody Shayo for this party. Kino Shele, Talongwe Muta, no Shimu. Mr. DJ, hit the music. Mofe Shayo, Mofe Kolo.
I'm a storyteller, and I would like to tell you a few personal stories about what I like to call the danger of the single story. I grew up on a university campus in eastern Nigeria. My mother says that I started reading at the age of 2, although I think 4 is probably close to the truth. So I was an early reader, and what I read were British and American children's books. I was also an early writer. And when I began to write at about the age of 7, stories in pencil with crayon illustrations that my poor mother was obligated to read, I wrote exactly the kinds of stories I was reading. All my characters were white and blue-eyed. They played in the snow. They ate apples. And they talked a lot about the weather, how lovely it was that the sun had come out.
Now this is David's house.
Now this, despite the fact that I lived in Nigeria, I had never been outside Nigeria. We didn't have snow. We ate mangoes. And we never talked about the weather because there was no need. My characters also drank a lot of ginger beer because the characters in the British books I read drank ginger beer. Never mind that I had no idea what ginger beer was. And for many years afterwards, I would have a desperate desire to taste ginger beer. But that is another story. What this demonstrates, I think, is how impressionable and vulnerable we are in the face of a story, particularly as children. Because all I had read were books in which characters were foreign, I had become convinced that books, by their very nature, had to have foreigners in them and had to be about things with which I...
How are you doing?
I'm fine, you're welcome.
Okay.
So, how are your sisters?
Well, they're fine. Okay, and I'm sending the greetings.
Thank you.
Look, you look gorgeous.
Oh, thank
what
you.
What about you tonight?
Mario, baby, I don't think I want to go.
Why?
I don't mean to hurt you, but I forgot to tell you the last time we called. I don't think I like that place.
Okay. What about taking you to Jazz 104?
I don't like that place either.
Why? It seems you don't want to go up with me.
I don't mean that. Okay, take me to my house.
Really?
Yes.
Come on, baby girl, come here with me. Oh, I'm so happy. Oh. Yeah, I can do it. Oh, come on, give me a kiss, man. Alright, put your things together and let me drop you over, okay? Chain sweets.
Did you promise us sweets?
Yes, I did.
Oh, we'll pick it on our way to our house.
Come on, see. I mean, I can't be taking you home. I'm so much happy when you're telling me to take you home. Look, listen to these sayings. It's all for you.
Okay.
Roses come and go. Gold, that's not gold. It is posed by the very flame. But love, true love, who can withhold it? It could be swayed into the winds, to and fro. So first, it could be withheld. Somehow, someday, it comes back to his home.
And when it does, it grows stronger.
Do you know the poem?
Yes, of course. Gloria Marquez's poem.
Oh my God, see, you're so intelligent.
With love, the world lives in color. And only pray to God you fall in love with a right person.
I took God to the majors. I am the right partner.
Of course you are.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm not lucky to find you.
My little sister, and the graduate of Unilag.
Oh, I'm not expecting anything less.
Thank you very much.
Are you sure you are really going now?
Ah, hey. Am I not ready to go out? Both of you are going to enjoy it. Don't worry, I'll be back soon. You, obviously, you go to bed. It's late.